Now, the answer is no. Within the population of everyone that took the BBC test, you guys are a sample. There are a lot of different samples we could take of all the people that took the test. We can take big samples and small samples. And while your sample could get the same averages as those from the entire population, there will also be samples that don't have the same averages. The average memory score of the population is called a population parameter, and it's denoted by mu. It's a funny little Greek symbol. And the average for the sample is called a sample statistic, and we generally denote it by X bar, an X with a bar on top. Now, I want to stress, please don't be nervous about symbols. I know a lot of people get pretty nervous when they see symbols that they haven't seen before, but in mathematics, we really need symbols to illustrate our points. Think of it like when you're playing a musical instrument and you have sheet music. How else are we going to make sure that people in future generations learn these classical melodies? Sheet music is the best way to do that. And same with in mathematics when we use symbols. We need to be able to articulate our thoughts to other people all around the world. And that's one thing that's really cool about mathematics. It's a universal language. So don't worry, you'll soon become familiar with these symbols because we're going to use them throughout this course. Now, we can use this sample statistic to approximate the population parameter, but generally they won't be exactly the same. The difference between these two is called the sampling error, which means we can make educated guesses about population parameters using sample statistics, but we probably won't be 100% accurate. That's why it's really important to have a good sample that can better predict the population parameter. So going back to the quiz, no, we don't think that the average scores for this class will be exactly the same, but it'll probably come close, and we're going to be able to see that later.